So in this part, I want to talk about what some people have referred to as the false light. And by the false light, well, maybe everyone has a different definition, I don't know, but I think what some people are suggesting is that whenever people are communicating with or receiving information from ascended masters, guides, angels, all of that sort of thing, they are in fact receiving information from a false light. Again, theme of the moment is, let's not throw the baby out with the bathwater, okay? So, point A, let's cut to the chase. I think that at the end of the day, yes, you don't need any middleman to go between you and your soul, your higher self, and whatever name you choose to call source energy by. So whether you call it source, God, the goddess, the divine, there's a clear highway between you and the divine, and you don't need anything or anyone to be your middleman for that. Now, with regards to other guides, at the end of the day, if you are communicating or receiving information from guides, angels, fairies, goddesses, you know, ascended masters, and if that helps you, if that makes you feel empowered, if that gives you clarity, if that makes you you know, feel guided in a way that is supportive and positive and just helps you live your life, helps you to have a strong connection to your own self, then fantastic, you know, yay. And where I think there is a problem or an issue, and I do see this quite a bit actually, is where people have this sense of, oh, well, I'm doing this because I was told to. You know, I was told to either by a reader or the cards or by ascended master, you know, whoever, or by my guides or whatever. And what they were told to do doesn't feel right or feel good or match what they actually feel to do. Okay, now, and I want to make the distinction between being, I guess, encouraged to do something that is out of your comfort zone, and that, of course, it's not going to feel comfortable because it's out of your comfort zone. So there's a big difference between that and what I'm talking about here. If you have received guidance, supportive encouragement to, say, change career or move or whatever, and yeah, it's going to feel challenging and it's going to get you out of your comfort zone and it's not going to be easy, it's going to feel a little bit hard in the initial days or weeks or months, that doesn't mean that it's bad guidance. It just means it's supportive, empowering guidance. It's getting you out of your comfort zone into your next level. Woohoo! I'm not talking about that. What I'm talking about is where you're kind of told, oh, I was told to, you know, leave my marriage, or I was told to leave this city and go in another city where I'm needed more. And if there's no sense to it, if it doesn't make sense to you, if it doesn't make sense to your mind or to your heart, if it feels downright weird, and if the only thing that is clicking at all is, well, I was told to, that is where I think people need to look at who are they receiving information from and what are they receiving information from. Okay, so something that I've always done, both for myself personally, whenever I've done a session, is I'll say, I'm connected to my higher self, I'm connected to the highest source of truth, love and light, I'm connected to the core and heart and center of Mother Earth. I also did that always on behalf of my clients. I would ask that whatever information comes through me comes from their higher self, their, you know, that they are connected to their highest source of truth, love and light and the core and heart of Mother Earth. And, you know, I did quite a few, you know, of those sorts of affirmations whenever I tuned into information for clients, and whenever I sort of just, well, went just day to day, you know, living for myself, I always, you know, say that. And, you know, sometimes if I forget to do that or forget to say that, I do, you know, you kind of feel like some static going on there or confusion. And I think that's just a really good way to get your hose clear to your own higher self and source. And again, use the words that are right for you. Use the affirmations that are right for you. If you do any cleansing, clearing practices, smudging with sage is great. But visualizing that you're being cleared under the shower is just as fine. Visualizing that you're being cleared of anything that doesn't belong to you, Just visualizing it is just as powerful. Do whatever you feel, but I think it is very important to have some sort of practice where you feel that you are connected to that which is truth for you, that which is the highest source of truth, love and light for you, and where you have a practice of clearing yourself. And I found that over the years, sometimes it just kind of happens automatically. I don't do it in a sort of a rote fashion as I used to. I find more that it kind of just happens. But I do find sometimes it's like you get an accumulation of static, and that's when I realize, oh wow, it's been a while since I actually did that. I need to do that. And it's kind of like if you don't shower regularly, you're going to get an accumulation of grime and dirt on you, right? So it's the same sort of thing. If you don't tune your television or your radio station to the right dial, you're going to get static, or you're going to end up on a channel that you don't want. Okay, so we need to be just as conscious and aware when it comes to our alignment with the true light. Your high, I don't really use that word, the true light. I more use the highest, you know, the highest source of truth, love and light. Just like you need to be specific with your channel on your television, just like you need to be consistent with your showers, your physical water showers, so too you need to be clear and focused with regards to what channel you want to be dialed up to on a day-to-day basis, and you also want to be clean and clear energetically. Okay, in the blog version, the written version of this particular topic, I've gone into detail about a really profound kind of a past life, in between lives kind of experience I had 18 months ago, that, you know, I don't know if it was so much, you know, going into a false light, but it definitely was going into the different goings on that are going on behind the scenes, in the non-physical as well as the physical, and the importance, I guess, of being aware of where is information coming from, and am I being guided in a good way here or not. So I can see why I've always been very, very strongly guided to keep dialing up and checking in every day with my team light, and my higher self, my truth source of love and light. Because, yeah, as I write in the blog, I have been aware of the alternate agenda. I have been aware of the ulterior motives. I have been aware of the elite and the psyops and everything from a long, long time ago, way before the internet. I always used to wonder how do I know this stuff? And that particular in between lives revealed some of that, of why, you know, I knew some of that. So it's fine to know about alternate agendas and ulterior motives, but I think being conscious of it and being aware of it and making sure you are clicking in and dialing up every day to your truth and to your highest source of truth, love and light allows you to approach that particular team and aspect of reality in a much more, well, in an empowering way. Okay, so I just want to finish up here. Actually, I'm going to finish up in the next part and do a really quick small part to end.